Hello friends, and welcome to this video. In this video, I am going to talk about jobs and careers. I have seen that a lot of people talk about careers, but then they aren't really even serious about the job that they are doing. So I thought that I'll just note down my observations and share them with all of you in the form of a very brief and short video. So let's go ahead. So what I have done is I have split people into four categories. Category one, which is the wage earners. Category two, the sincere doers. Category three, the career builders. And category four, the chosen few. Now, the percentages that I have written here are based on my own experience and judgment only. I haven't got any survey done for doing these calculations. But this is based on my experience of about 28 years in my professional career. And I have seen a number of people who are behaving differently. So 50% of people are mostly wage earners. 40% may be sincere doers. 9% may be career builders. And 1% are the chosen few. So let's go ahead and look at all of them. The wage earners. So 50% of the people are only earning money. Their thinking is mostly day to day or month to month. There's hardly any long term thinking that they are doing. And as a result, there is hardly any long term growth that happens in their career. Most of them are ignorant about many things like quality of work, their own personal development, and so on. Many of them don't even know where they would be after maybe 10 years or 20 years, or even where they would like to be after 10 or 20 years. For them, better opportunity simply means higher salary and or more perks. So they are just looking at increase in salary more than development of the self. These are the wage earners. They work for salary or wages and they are not thinking long term. Let's look at the second category. The second category is the sincere doers. About 40% of people, I think, fall into this particular category. They are doing a job. And while they are doing that job, they are trying to fulfill their duties and responsibilities properly. They are even open to learning new skills. Yes, they do think about future. They mostly think about next 3 to 7 years or maybe 10 years max. One of the problems with them is they depend on others for their growth. This is a category of people who can be motivated by their leaders and managers easily to do better. Their growth is limited by the number of opportunities that come their way. Some of them may actively look for opportunities to develop themselves, whereas others would by far and large depend on the opportunities to come to them. Let's look at the next category. The career builders. About 9% of the total, I think, are falling into this category. The career builders think about building their career. Most of them are thinking long term, maybe 50 or 20 years from today. They take ownership of developing their own career. They actively identify and spot career opportunities. Some of them may also create opportunities for themselves as well as others. They know from an early age what they want to be, and they work really hard to get there. I know a lot of people who know what they want right from their school age. So they know they want to become doctors, engineers, politicians, scientists, and so on. And not just they know it, they even work very hard to reach there. Let's go to the final category of people. I call them as the chosen few. And they probably are 1% or less of the total. When they are working, they are typically responding to a higher call. Maybe they know what God has in store for them. Maybe they listen to God's voice. They have a very, very developed conscience. And what they do is what their conscience allows them to do. What they do is what they are told to do. And they actually are sensitive to their job and their responsibilities towards the society at large. They are doing what they are asked to do by the supreme power. And by that, I mean God. In the process, their career develops in a way that no one else could have imagined or planned. I call them as the chosen few, and they are chosen by the Almighty to get the things done that He wants. Some interesting facts. So there can be a shift from category 1, which is the wage earners, to category 2, which is the sincere doers, after maybe an initial 4 or 5 years of experience. Similarly, there can be a shift from the sincere doers to the career builders, that is category 2 to category 3. Well, unfortunately, there may also be a shift from the sincere doers to a wage earner, or even from the career builders to wage earners. Category 4 are extremely spiritual people with an inner guiding force, though it may not be very obvious. I have even noticed that many of them seem like atheists, but the inner drive is so strong that they ultimately do what they are needed to do. Many people in category 3 may actually shift to category 4 later on. Some of them may even coexist in category 3, which is career builders, as well as the chosen few, that is category 4. Many entrepreneurs, teachers, doctors, scientists, soldiers, and even some politicians, I think, come in category 4. They are the chosen few. In contrast to what the job title suggests, many senior management executives actually fall in category 1. They are just wage earners. They are not even sincere doers. Many lower management positions may actually be in category 3. And I have seen a lot of security guards. I have seen a lot of office assistants who think about their office as their company. They have a sense of ownership. And they do much more than even what a sincere doer will do to make sure that their organization is benefited. They never run away from responsibilities. In fact, they try to take better and more responsibilities. So the categories do not really depend on the management levels at which one is working. Well, that brings me to the end of this particular presentation, which was very brief. Questions for you. To which category do you belong? And finally, what can you do to move on to the next category? Hope you like the video. Feel free to give feedback. Thank you very much.